Hey, so in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the quantification tool in Navisworks, how to create quantification takeoffs, how to export them in XLS or CSV formats. So let's get started. This is the Revit model we're going to be using in this tutorial. You can download it from the link in the description below. You'll just go to this link and then scroll down until you find the model that you want to download and simply select it. Now we'll go back to Revit, go to File, Export, and NWC. Obviously, if you don't have the NWC export tool, you can also go to the link in the description below. This is the link. You'll just scroll down until you find the download Navisworks NWC file export utility. You'll just follow the steps. It's really simple, the installation process. Just choose the version of the Navisworks that you are using. Back to Revit. Now you will export. We'll give our file a name, for example, Navis or quantification test version 1. But the most important thing is our Navisworks settings. This is what I say in all the tutorials. Make sure to convert the element IDs, all the element parameters, the element properties. Go all the way down to coordinates. The project internal coordinates should be selected. Then export, whether you want to export the current view or the entire project, it's up to you. Then check the try and find the missing materials, and then you're good to go. We'll hit export, and now we will launch our Navisworks manage. We will append our model, or our element, our file. And here we are. As usual, as soon as we launch Navisworks, we'll find the guy with a hard hat. So you'll just have to right click, go to viewpoint and navigation tools, and enable the third person. Now, up to the home menu, we're going to go to the quantification or to our takeoff tool. That's our quantification workbook, and we're gonna go do our project setups to choose the catalog to organize our takeoff projects. I usually use a uniformat, but for this tutorial, I'm gonna go with none. The metric system, next. And now I won't be changing any of these units. I'm gonna show you how to do that later. And now we're gonna go to our selection tree and simply select our whole model in the standard view. Right click and go to quantification and then take off to new catalog item. It won't take long. And then we'll find the results in our quantification workbook. Well, this tool simply allows you to count the elements in your model and at the same time measure any area or length or volume that you need to measure, so you can spend more time analyzing this data and not actually having to calculate it. It's a very useful tool, usually used by architects and engineers, and commonly called as takeoff more than quantification. Now we're gonna export our book or workbook all the way to the right and export catalog to Excel. Give it a random name and simply hit save. It wouldn't take long as well. And then we will open our file. And that's our workbook that has all the data that's relevant to our model. This is simply the most basic way and the fastest way to do the quantification of your model. Now I'm going to show you how to select certain elements or certain category if you want to do a specific quantification. Now back to Navisworks. So as you can see, our model has been color-coded based on the elements in it. But now we'll just go back to our quantification workbook and simply delete this virtual catalog. Go to item catalog and just simply delete it. And now we will create a new item catalog and name it, for example, pipes. Therefore, we're going to select all the pipes in the model and do their quantification takeoffs. go to find items tool, go to category, choose category, property name, condition will be equal, and the value will obviously be the pipes in our model, and then hit find all. Now Navisworks has selected all the pipes in our model, as you can see here. Now we'll go to the selection tree, right click our selection and go to quantification takeoff to specifically the pipes category or the pipes catalog. Go to our quantification book and there are our results. Scroll to the right, export as usual to Excel. Give it a name and check your report. As usual, you get all the data relevant to the type of element or the category that you have chosen to do the quantification for. And now we'll go back to Navisworks. I'm going to show you what to do if you want to change the units after already performing the quantification process. Go to item catalog right under the color and the opacity of the item. We're going to go all the way down to units and change the unit of each variable. You can also change the formula. For example, if you want to check or to review or change the formula of any of the variables suggested by Navisworks, you can do that. But in certain situations, you may need a certain variable in your takeoff that is not provided or not already set in here by Navisworks. In this situation, for example, assuming we're going to go to the pipes and find the properties of our pipes, check around and realize that there are no length in these properties, which means that there is a missing variable. We're going to need to add the length variable to our quantification process. Right then, we will close the property tab and go back to our item catalog and go to property mapping. Add a new property. In this situation, it's going to be the model length. The category will be the length of the element. And the property will be length with no numbers in front of it. So yeah, length. And press OK. That way we had made sure that we added this property to our quantification process. Obviously, you can check in the properties whether the length has been added. And there it is. And calculated. And yes, that's it for today. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comments, or if you're interested in my content, you can simply like or subscribe or watch the rest of my videos if you really are interested in Navisworks and learning how to use all the Navisworks tools. So yeah, thank you.